what must be done to vaccinate everyone against COVID-19. In just a few months, pharmaceutical companies have produced millions of doses of COVID-19 vaccines worldwide. But these aren't enough to inoculate most people across continents. So what does it take to vaccinate the world's population against COVID-19? The answer is to address the challenges from vaccine production to intellectual property. According to Nature, a single vaccine dose can require up to 200 various components, including the vial, filters, resins, tubing, and disposal bags. These components are not readily available locally, so manufacturers must import them. This is why supply lines got impaired when the pandemic began. Richard Hatchett, chief executive of the Coalition for Epidemic Preparedness Innovation, said, "If any critical item falls short, then it can disrupt the entire process." The main target is to vaccinate at least 70% of the world's population to trigger herd immunity everywhere. To achieve that, billions of doses are required to vaccinate nearly everyone against the disease. But why can't companies work faster to produce this enormous amount? They are doing the fastest possible speed now, and some even work together to scale up production. What is more likely to slow things down is the technology of the vaccine. mRNA is the most innovative technology that yielded Pfizer's and Moderna's vaccines. While these vaccines are effective, creating them is quite tricky. First, you need specially trained people on making mRNA vaccines. Second, you have to find an excellent source of key ingredients like enzymes, lipids, and nucleotides. Because mRNA vaccines are new, there are fewer trained people and fewer suppliers of key components. Despite millions of doses already shipped and administered to many people, most nations have insufficient supplies. High-income nations are one reason why there's a shortage in vaccine doses. They only represent one-fifth of the world, yet they bought 6 billion doses already. Low-income nations represent four-fifths and only got about 2.6 billion doses. One possible way to balance the distribution of vaccines is by temporarily suspending intellectual property rights until the pandemic is over. The suspension will enable more manufacturers to produce vaccines. Unfortunately, this proposition isn't a guaranteed solution with concerns expected to arise if implemented. Thus, the WHO is now looking at coordinated technology transfer to allow entities to license their vaccines to other companies using the organization. But whatever solution they come up with, it's badly needed because Africa is in a huge gap. The continent is buying 99% of vaccine doses due to the lack of local manufacturers. In early March, 179 million doses were produced. Of that, 43% were mRNA, 35% were whole virus, and 22% were viral vector vaccines.